try to believe, though the going gets rough, that you gotta hang tough to make it. History repeats itself, try and you succeed. Never doubt that you're the one, and you can have your dream. You're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever keep you down. You're the best around. And nothing's gonna ever keep you down. You're the best around. Welcome back to Old Time Best College Basketball Edition. This show goes position by position for one school to put together the all-time best two-deep lineup. Today, we turn our attention to the Purdue Boilermakers. We start out at point guard, and this is a tricky position to choose for Purdue. Consequently, I'm going with a guy that played more at shooting guard, but could certainly handle a point in 6'4", Etwan Moore. He's the school's all-time leader in three-point field goals made, third in points scored, top 10 in assists, and is one of only three players in Big Ten history to tally 2,000 points, 500 rebounds, and 400 assists in a career. He was an All-Big Ten selection during each of his 4 years, earning 2 second-team honors and 2 first-team selections. He helped the team to the 2009 Big Ten tournament title and the regular season championship in 2010. He was a Wooden Award finalist and honorable mention All-American during his senior year. He was selected in the second round of the 2011 NBA draft by the Celtics, where he played as a reserve for one season before signing with the Magic, where he started 21 games, contributing 7.8 points and 2.7 assists per game. Shooting guard. This spot goes to the school's all-time scoring leader and two-time first-team All-American, the 6'4" Rick Mount. The highly touted guard was the first high school player ever to appear on the Sports Illustrated cover. As a sophomore, he made his varsity debut scoring more than 28 points per game and earning second-team All-American honors. As a junior, Mount averaged more than 33 points per game, leading the team to a Big Ten title and the finals of the NCAA tournament. As a senior, Mount's scoring prowess was on full display with 2 53-point games and a 61-point outburst against conference champ Iowa, averaging over 35 points per game and once again winning the Big Ten Player of the Year. He holds the school record with 46 games, scoring 30-plus points, and is the only player ever to average more than 30 points per game in a career. He was the first overall pick in the 1970 ABA draft by the Indiana Pacers, winning an ABA championship in 1972. Small forward, perhaps the most dominating player in Purdue history, locks up this spot in the form of the 6'7" Glenn Big Dog Robinson. In just 2 seasons, Robinson managed to climb to 8th on the all-time scoring list. During his first season, Robinson averaged over 24 points and 9 rebounds per game, earning first-team All-Big Ten honors and a second-team All-American selection. His next season was even more incredible as he led the Big Ten Conference in both scoring and rebounding for the first time since 1978. He led the team to a Big Ten Conference title, a 29-5 record, and a trip to the Elite Eight. He became the first Boilermaker since 1932 to garner National Player of the Year honors, taking home every major award. He was the first overall pick in the 94 NBA draft by the Milwaukee Bucks. He was a 2-time All-Star that scored over 14,000 points, the most by any former Boilermaker. Power forward. There's no less than 6 players that merit serious consideration here, but I'm giving the nod to the scrappiest in 6'8" Brian Cardinal. He finished his career as the school's all-time leader in steals, an amazing feat for a power forward. During each of his 4 seasons, he helped the team win games in the NCAA tournament, advancing to the second round as a freshman, consecutive Sweet 16 appearances during his sophomore and junior year, and advancing to the Elite Eight as a senior. He twice earned all Big Ten honors, but made his mark with his all-out style of play, becoming the only player in Purdue history to win the Mr. Hustle and Courage Team Awards 4 years in a row. He was taken in the second round of the 2000 NBA draft by the Pistons, but played sparingly until he signed with the Warriors in 2004 and was a finalist for the Most Improved Player Award, sparking an 8-year run as a productive reserve that culminated in an NBA title with the Dallas Mavericks in 2011. Center. This one's a no-brainer. The school's all-time leading rebounder and shot blocker, 7-foot Joe Barry Carroll. His 2,175 points ranks second all-time behind only Rick Mount. As a freshman, he recorded a triple-double with 16 points, 16 rebounds, and a single-game record 11 blocks. He was twice named first-team All-Big Ten and earned All-American honors in 1980 when he led the Boilermakers to a 23-10 record and an appearance in the Final Four. He's the only Boilermaker with more than 2,000 points and 1,000 rebounds. He was the first overall pick in the 1980 NBA draft by the Warriors. He earned all-rookie first-team honors in 81 and was an all-star in 87. In total, he scored more than 12,000 points and grabbed over 5,000 rebounds during his 10-year career. Now we move on to second team, starting again at point guard, and this is a dead heat between five players. The school's all-time assist leader Bruce Parkinson could be the choice, but his good but not great shooting percentage led me to pass on him. Brian Walker compiled the second most assists in school history and was a great floor leader, but averaged less than 5 points per game, so I'm passing on him as well. Porter Roberts ranks fifth in career assists, but had an abysmal shooting percentage and less than 100 steals. Matt Waddell was nearly my choice, ranking sixth in assists, shooting a solid 45% from the field with more than 100 three-pointers. But ultimately, I went with the floor general of the three amigos, the 6'2" Everett Stevens. He's tied for the third most assists in school history. He's seventh in steals, and amazingly, eighth in block shots. He also shot 49.9% from the field, one of the highest in school history for a guard. He helped the Boilermakers win back-to-back Big Ten championships in 87 and 88. He was a second-round draft choice in the 1988 NBA draft, but played only small parts of two seasons in the league, spending the majority of his pro career in the CBA. Shooting guard. While Keith Edmondson, Chad Austin, and Jerron Cornell deserve a mention here, the primary scoring punch from the three amigos gets the spot, and that's 6'4" Troy Lewis. The fifth leading scorer in school history, Lewis was a three-time All-Big Ten selection, bringing home first-team honors in 87 and 88. He led the team in scoring three straight seasons, helping the school win two Big Ten titles. A highly efficient shooter, he's tied with Everett Stevens for the second-highest three-point shooting percentage for a career. He still ranks ninth in school history for three-pointers made, despite playing two seasons before the line was implemented. Surprisingly, he went undrafted by the NBA and never played in the league. Small forward. This is a tough choice. Dave Schellhaus is the only 2,000-point scorer not to make the team. Quanzo Martin holds the school record for three-point shooting percentage and was nearly my choice, but I just cannot leave off 6'7" swingman Terry Dischinger. He was a three-time All-American, earning consensus first-team honors in both 61 and 62. He holds school records for rebounding average, free throws made, and double-doubles. His 28.3 career scoring average is the third highest. He scored 40 or more points, a school record, nine different times. He was selected 8th overall in the 62 NBA draft and won Rookie of the Year honors in 63. He was a three-time All-Star that scored over 9,000 points and grabbed more than 3,600 rebounds in a very productive nine-year career. Power forward. I considered three amigo forward Todd Mitchell and his successor Melvin McCants, as well as Carl Landry, but in the end I had to choose 6'8" Robbie Hummel. He was the first player ever to serve as team captain for 4 years. He earned all Big Ten honors four times, including three first-team selections. His all-around game was so strong he litters the Purdue record books, ranking 9th in school history for points scored, 4th in rebounds and three-pointers made, 6th in free throw percentage, 7th in block shots and assist-to-turnover ratio, 11th in steals, and 14th in double-doubles. He helped lead the team to back-to-back Big Ten championships in 2009 and 2010. He was drafted in the second round of the 2012 NBA draft by the Timberwolves, but has yet to make it in the league, currently playing professionally in Spain. Center. Stephen Scheffler only had one great season, so this really comes down to either Brad Miller or Juwan Johnson. Miller has the advantage in field goal percentage and had a strong pro career. However, I give the nod to the 6'10" Juwan Johnson. He scored more points in total, averaged more per game, and was nearly dead even in rebounds, all while blocking 100 more shots than Miller, which is what pushed him over the edge for me. His 263 blocks rank him second behind only Joe Barry Carroll, while his 854 rebounds are the fifth highest total in school history. He was a consensus All-American in 2011, the first in 17 years, while becoming the first ever Boilermaker to win the Pete Newell National Big Man of the Year Award. He was the third Big Ten player ever to be named both Player of the Year and Defensive Player of the Year in the same season. He shares the program record for games won with teammate Etwan Moore with 107. He was a first-round pick in the 2011 NBA draft and played 36 games for the Celtics before landing in the D-League. So there you go, the all-time best Purdue Boilermakers men's basketball team. Remember, if you've got a request for a school you'd like to see on an upcoming episode, just post it here and we'll see you next time on All-Time Best, College Basketball Edition.